Hello students, today let us start a new poem. The name of the poem is Invictus, okay? And I am on page number 27. So let us start this poem Invictus. First of all, what is the meaning of Invictus? The meaning of Invictus is unconquered. What is the meaning of Invictus? Unconquered, right? Okay, so before going to the poem, let us discuss about the warming up activities. Now, some warming up activities are given here. What you have to do, you have to solve this warming up activity and you have to do that as homework and have to send me. Okay, so what is the first warming up activity? It says, let's introspect. Okay, let's introspect. What is given in the poem? Before that, let us introspect ourselves. The activity is think and respond with yes or no. What you have to do, you have to respond whether this is what you think about the given thing, whether you have to respond either yes or in either no. What it says, when you are faced with a very serious problem and grave dangers, what do you experience? See, very important thing is asked there. It says, whenever you faced any kind of serious problems in life, at that time, how you respond to the problems? Okay, that is very important, how we respond to the problem. Whenever we face any kind of grave dangers in life, at that time, how we respond to that dangers? Okay, that actually depends on our attitude, how we look towards the thing. Sorry, how we see towards the things. See, basically what happens, those people are successful in life. What they generally do, they face the problem, they face the challenges, they think, they actually find out the solution from the problems. And there are certain people are there, what they generally do, so they, whenever they find a problem standing in front of them, what they generally do, they try to run away from some other way, or they try to find out some shortcuts in that. Okay, and because of that, they are unsuccessful. They do not able to get success in life. And that is why what we need to do, we need to find out the solution. Then we can be unconquerable. We will be Invictus. Understood? So this poem is actually talking about that. This poem is talking about the things that actually the poet is talking, that whenever he faces the problems, he do not run away from the problem, but he faces the problem. Okay, and a very interesting poem is there. Before that poem, let us see what he is asking. Okay, one more thing I would like to tell you. There are certain people one in Hindi, one proverb is there. So recently I heard that proverb means, in spite of running away from the current situation. Now we all know that current situation is not very good. Corona's pandemic is going anywhere, everywhere. Okay? And out of that, some people are trying to run away from that. But in spite of running away from the problem, we must face it. Okay, with alertness, in spite of क्या बोलते हैं उसको कि बीमारी से लड़ना है हमको बीमार से नहीं. And nowadays what is happening, many people are actually running from the bimars or the from the people, those who are suffering with this. So we have to understand that आपत्ति में what is that विपत्ति में अवसर ढूंढना. Vipatti mein ausar dhoondna, finding opportunities in grave situations. Okay, that is very important. Okay, anyway, let us talk on this warming up activity. So it says, when you face any serious problem, what do you do? So what you're feeling? You become panic or wish you were never born. What thought come in your mind that you have to tick there? You have to tell whether you becomes panic by seeing the situation, or you think, you wish that, hey, oh God, you were never born, or you feel hopelessness, okay, you feel hopelessness, or there is no emotion, you do not, do not feel anything, there is no emotion inside you, or you think calmlessly and calmness and composure, then willing to tackle it, or you try to tackle the problem. So exactly what happens with that, that you have to respond. Now next one is given, break down and cry. There are certain peoples maybe, when they find any of the problem, any of the danger in front of them, they cry and break down. Okay, don't do like this. They run away and hide. Sometimes it happens that we run away and we hide from that particular problems. Most of the time it happens whenever we are guilty for some of the things, we try to hide and run away from that thing. The pray to God. Most of the people, they generally what they do, say this, you know, God save me, Bhagwan, kya ho gaya? Because in such situations only we remember God. Some of you maybe ask for help. What will be your reaction in, whenever you see the problem? You may ask for help. See, what you have to do, you have to, out of this, whatever your feelings and whatever your reactions would be there, you have to take that. Okay, it is very easy. Build up courage. Some would be there, those who build up courage, and you will see, let us see what is going to happen and face it. There may be someone like that. Someone would be there who will say, let me take it as a challenge and see it, what is going to happen. Okay, so certain different things will depends upon the nature and attitude of individuals. You have to do that. Okay, next one. Write about your feeling and reactions in 4 to 5 lines. You may describe your feeling and reaction using the other word than given here. So what you have to do, considering the above question, whenever you face any serious problem or grave dangers, how will you respond to that? You have to express your feelings in 4 to 5 lines. Okay, it is very easy and very important also. So express that. Then second activity, form a group is given before that, but now we cannot form the group, so leave that. Come to second one. Guess what the following symbols and match the pair. Some of the symbols are given here, and what these symbols are meant for, or why we use these symbols, for what we generally use the symbols. Tall mountain, a dark night, a rose, a sunrise, a flying bird, a thunder. So what generally these things describes, or what are the symbols, what they are symbols of. For example, if a tall mountain, if you have to discuss, then we can say strength and firmness. Okay, strength and firmness. Mountain stands for strength and firmness. Adik khada rehta hai mountain, hilta dulta nahi hai bilkul. Okay, so for this it is used. So you have to complete this also. Okay, and send this as a homework. So let us stop for here in today's video. In next video we are going to see the explanation of the poem. Till then, bye.